Hi guys, welcome to Financial Brilliance, the channel where you learn financial topics. Be sure to smash that like button, subscribe to our channel, and comment below. Help us with the YouTube algorithm. Without further ado, let's talk finance.
Thanks for that great introduction. I want to give credit to First Street Financial Advisors for sponsoring this video. They are financial planners, advisors, and coaches. For a monthly fee, they can help you develop a financial plan for your future. They can be contacted by clicking the link in the description below. Anyway, I don't know if you have met me. My name is Will. I'm a baker and I live in New York City. A couple of years ago, I started my own bakery. We expanded rapidly and now I need $20,000 to buy new machinery. I just found an excellent recipe for Asiago cheese bagels. And I need new and faster ovens to cook my delicious bagels. Anyway, all of my cash is tied up in other projects. I purchased a new cash register and display case. Unfortunately, I still owe money to the bank for those items. So I need to raise money to bake those delicious Asiago cheese bagels. I have a few options. Number one, I can issue new shares in my business to raise money. Number two, I can take a loan out from the bank. Number three, I can take a loan out from the public by selling interest paying corporate bonds. Selling shares in my business can be tricky, and I have no interest in losing my ownership. A couple of years ago, I issued shares and sold them to my friends. I only own 10% of my company now, and I don't want to dilute my ownership further. Taking out a loan from the bank can be a difficult process, and it would be on the bank's terms. Plus, I already owe the bank for my cash registers and display case. Or I could issue corporate bonds and pay interest to investors. You see, corporate bonds are debt instruments created by companies for the purpose of raising capital. In this case, I needed capital to buy faster ovens for my bagels. Corporate bonds are called fixed income securities because they pay a specified amount of interest on a regular basis. I will have to ask my friends to see if they know other people interested in buying my bakery's corporate bonds. The bond itself represents a loan agreement between the issuer and the investor. The terms of the bond obligate the issuer, my bakery, to repay the borrowed amount, the principal, by a specific date, the maturity, to my bakery's investors. So, I checked what certificates of deposit at the local bank were paying. Only 1% interest per year. That means I only need to pay slightly above that rate to attract new investors. Seems pretty cheap. Maybe I'll also throw in a free Asiago cheese bagel with my bakery's corporate bonds. I talked to my accountant. He said that we had to determine how many years we wanted the bakery's bond payments to go on for and how high the interest rate we would be willing to pay. He explained that some bond maturities are short term, a year or less. Others are intermediate term, usually 2 to 10 years. And many are long term, a period of 10 to 30 years or more. The face value or par value of a bond represents the amount to be repaid at maturity. I went with third option and decided to issue long-term bonds. All of the money will be paid back in 30 years. I looked at current interest rates in the market and set a coupon rate, also known as the bond's interest rate. The certificate of deposit at the bank was paying 1% interest per year. Therefore, I had to charge a higher interest rate. You see, banks in the United States are insured by the FDIC up to $250,000. That means that your money is guaranteed by the federal government up to $250,000. If the bank fails, you will receive your money back. However, my bonds are guaranteed only by the success of my bakery. They are not government insured. If my bakery does not sell any pastries and bagels, the bonds will be worthless. With that in mind, my accountant advised me to pay 3% interest per year on the bakery's bond because the interest rate is higher than a bank's rate. Hopefully, investors would buy my bakery bonds because they would earn a higher rate of return. The bakery's investors would take on more risk because I'm offering them higher return. I had to decide payment terms by setting the coupon period and maturity date. My accountant and I decided that a 30-year period would lock our interest rate until 2050s. Interest rates might go higher in the future, so it was important to us to lock in the rate for 30 years. Finally, we had to determine the price of the bakery bonds. A typical bond on the market sells for $1,000 per bond. Since we needed $20,000, I needed to issue 20 bonds. It's important to note that bonds can be traded on secondary markets. That means my bakery bonds can be resold to other investors. The original owners can sell their bonds to other investors. The bakery bonds' resale value are affected by interest rates. As interest rates go up, bond prices go down. If you are the original owner of the bakery bond and hold it for 30 years, you should get all your money back plus interest. You will lose your money if my bakery goes bankrupt and I can't make the payments, or if interest rates go really high and you try to resell your bonds. You will receive less money because investors will seek other investments with higher rates of interest. Now, sit back and get an Asiago cheese bagel. I'm making some right now. If you enjoyed this video and want to experience more like this, hit the subscribe button below. And don't forget to hit that like button.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and want to experience more financially brilliant topics, kindly smash that subscribe button now. Just do it. You won't regret it. I'm off to get a cup of tea. Earl Grey, perhaps? Please list in the comment section your favorite cup of tea. Anyway, stay financially brilliant.